What is going on?
As much as I wish Ursa was here to kill you, I don't mind doing it for her.
Go ahead. I'm not afraid. Except that knowing you, Eren, you'll screw it up!
I know what you are afraid of. Going back to Mainspring in chains. Every clan in the claim wants you dead. And they know how to make it hurt. They'll even bid for the privilege.
It's just like you to get someone else to do your killing.
Shut up! You're at the Sun King's mercy now.
Aloy, to say you have my gratitude feels woefully insufficient. You saved my life. You saved Meridian. And because of you, there will be justice for Ursa's murder. We can mourn her knowing the truth without painful uncertainty. It's hard to imagine where we'd be without you. And I don't want to try. I hope you will consider staying in Meridian.
Were you and Ursa, you know.
I suppose it's obvious how I feel, how I felt about her. She didn't just give me advice. She gave me strength. But we couldn't be together. Relations between the Carja and Oseram and Meridian were unsteady as it was. The union of the Sun King and an Oseram warrior would have led to open revolt in the city. And probably war with the clans.
Did anyone know?
Only one. Derval. He wanted Ursa, but she rejected him. And so jealousy became yet another of his hateful motivations.
What exactly will happen to Derval?
For now, he'll languish in one of the old cells under the Sunring here in Meridian. As for what happens after we negotiate his extradition to Mainspring, I don't want to think about it. My father was very creative when it came to inflicting suffering. But some Oseram devices surpass even his imaginings. What a waste. Derval is a brilliant man. I wonder what he would have accomplished if it weren't for my father's cruelty.
Why do you want me to stay in Meridian?
Well, I would think that would be obvious.
Not to me.
Huh. Well, to start with, you kept the city from going up in flames. You're strong, shrewd, and capable. I could use someone like you at my side.
Thank you for the offer, but I don't think either you or I are ready for that. At least, not yet. I've got a long way to go before I find what I'm looking for, and it's gonna take me far from Meridian.
Well, of course. I didn't mean to presume. You are your own woman, just as Ersa was. But please, remember that you're always welcome here. I hope that today is just a sunrise for us, not a goodbye.
It's time for me to go.
Of course. I hope you find what you're after, Aloy. And if need be, I will come to your aid. As sure as the sun's rising.
Okay. And talk to Davin. The wall, so I call him Davin the Red.
I have a matter of grace and beauty I would like to discuss with you.
That added probably nothing to the story.
No, a colorful discussion.
I was just thinking about Ersa. She would have killed Dervahl on the spot. I know it. That's why she went out to meet him in the first place, to put him down. But she also told me to grow up. I got to admit, it burned a little when she said that, but I'm trying to take it to heart. And I guess growing up means putting what you should do in front of what you want to do, right?
You're asking me? I'm pretty sure you're older.
Yeah, but I don't act like it, do I?
You did with Dervahl.
Don't give me too much credit. Part of me still wants to wait for a quiet moment and wring his neck.
Yeah, but you won't. Because you're a good captain.
Come on, stop. You're gonna make me tear up.
Mm-hmm.
So, after all this, what's next for Errand Vanguardsman?
Heading back to the claim for a while. I'll get in touch with my clan and we'll lay Ersa to rest properly. Like how she would have wanted. And by that I mean less chit-chat, more drinking.
Hmm.
What do you think the Oseram will do to Dervahl?
First off, they'll argue about it for a long time. But whatever they come up with, it won't be quick. I can live with that. In fact, I might just drop by his cell under the sun ring to remind him what's coming.
Well,
I know. You gotta go. Killers to track, machines to master. All before breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? When we met, I thought I was a big shot talking to a pretty girl hidden away in the middle of nowhere. Now I see that I was just lucky to get a minute of your time. Try not to forget about me while you're out there changing the world.
I'll always have a minute for you. Maybe even two.
Two? Huh. She likes me.
Hmm. Okay. Find a use for the power stone? No. Me. You do our quest? No. Kill a cultivist and the death bin, yeah. Should see if we can craft any more packs.
The snow's got a bite out here.
Might have to climb to catch her.
Oh.
thing really hurt it.
I'm more fire resistant now. Climb back up to the corpse. Yeah, yeah, you're shooting at me. Okay.
Haven't you got anything better to do?
Yeah, I got everything off you. It's good.
Did it. Those things pack a punch. All right. The Eclipse officer had a focus. Let's see what's on it. Let's see what you have to say. What is this?
The entity lives. Unacceptable. Unacceptable. Unacceptable.
What the hell was that? Hades? Hey! Mysterious stranger, did you see that? No answer, huh? Figures. Things just keep getting strange. I need to find a way inside the tower.
Okay.
Hold for identity scan. Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. Please step inside.
What is this then? Like another cauldron? Or something else completely different?
You are 354,510 days overdue for your meeting with Mr. Farrell. Please proceed to the 35th floor.
Wait, this is like
350,000. That's hundreds of years ago.
Yeah, she's like a great, 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 great grandma, I'm guessing. Well, humans have developed something that makes you immortal, or at least lives longer than 100 years.
A Deathbringer, or a statue of one in my... and they honored it?
Welcome to Pharaoh.
What was this place? What were they doing here?
It was a corporation. A group of people not unlike a tribe. And they made machines.
Yeah, go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your focus. They'll help you understand.
This sounds like a guy from Destiny. What do you call it? A Titan Commander. Maybe he's a simp voice actor. Most likely. This sounds like a guy from Destiny.
The air. There's no smell to it. Not even old death. Another cave in. But I could get through.
Yeah, this one's easy.
I bet I can use that as a ramp to get back up.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you want me to go up? Okay. I had no idea.
Looks like I can climb here. Okay, I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing right now. Okay, that explains nothing. Hey, oh man, can I do this? No, we can't. Blue WDWDA. Oh, come on, that was working fine. Okay. Look at there's things over there, I didn't notice them. Okay, there's things over there. Right. Well, the thing they dropped down once, maybe he's telling me. Oh, wait a minute, I can see a thingy by there. Yeah, there's a thingy by there, an orange thingy. Here we go. Looks like the way up. What's left of it?
Hmm.
most of the way. Not making this easy, Dr. Sobeck.
Uh-huh.
If plants can find a way to hang on up here, I guess I can too.
Uh-huh. What's in your arm? Probably not pain. Whoa. Okay, interesting. What's up, Yaren?
Offensive operations against robots and human personnel of the Hearts Timor Energy Combine. Now I wish that I could relate that the crisis has been exaggerated, but it's not. The peacekeepers have not responded to stand down codes, and by all signs, they appear to be replicating at a precipitous rate. Now what I can promise, can absolutely assure you, is that I am already devoting every possible resource towards reaching a speedy conclusion to this issue.
Peacekeepers. That's what they called their machines. They were built for war, not peace.
Well, actually, maybe originally they were. I don't know. Dude, what are you doing? Alright guys, I actually have to leave that episode today, so don't forget to like button, subscribe, join me today, I'll see you guys in the next episode, peace.